I'd like to talk about the scientific legacy of Viking. The science that came out of Viking 40 years ago is still being analyzed as we speak. The Viking landing sequence, it's never been done successfully before. It's called Entry, Descent, and Landing, EDL. You have to have successful EDL or you don't have an operating spacecraft on the surface of Mars. Viking actually wrote the book on how to do this successfully. During entry in the aeroshell, as Viking entered the atmosphere of Mars, we made the first in situ measurements of the atmosphere of Mars, and among other things, discovered the presence of nitrogen in the atmosphere of Mars. Nitrogen is very important if you're interested in life on Mars because nitrogen is a key ingredient. Mars may have lost 99% of its atmosphere over geological time because the light isotope preferentially leaves the planet because it's a little bit lighter. The heavier isotope stays. And so Viking gave us the first real indication that Mars lost the bulk of its atmosphere, and that also explains why there's no surface water on Mars today. It cannot exist in such a thin atmosphere, and Viking measurements gave the indication. Viking is the only mission to Mars to ever have experiments to search for active life on Mars. If you have life, you have organic molecules. And the Viking gas chromatograph mass spectrometer did not show evidence of organic molecules, carbon-based molecules, on the surface of Mars. Viking provided a new picture of planet Mars, and Viking provided us data that to this day, 40 years later, we are still analyzing. The Viking orbiters obtained 52,000 images of the surface of Mars. The Viking landers obtained 4,500. This is the first photograph, and if you look at the left side of the photograph, this photograph was generated as strips, and you can see some dark streak in the left. And what that streak is dust. When Viking landed, it caused the dust to rise, and a few minutes later, that dust fell back, and that's what we're seeing. The interesting thing is that we are still analyzing the Viking images for potential landing sites for the first human mission of Mars.